Good day from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see some CP time data plots. Later in the lead optimization process, the discovery team will need real CP time data to determine the in vivo PK behavior of a molecule. On the screen are two CP time graphs. The graph on the left is for a molecule administered by an IV bolus. The entire dose is injected almost instantaneously into a vein of an animal, likely a rat. On the right is a CP time curve for an orally administered dose. Remember that the absorption phase involves a molecule traveling from its site of administration to the central compartment, the plasma. Therefore, in the IV bolus curve, there is no absorption phase, since the molecule is injected into the blood. Absorption is completely bypassed, and CP starts very high. In contrast, for oral administration, there is a lag from the time of administration, time zero, until the molecule can be detected in the plasma. The concentration rises as the molecule is absorbed along the GI tract until it tapers off as the rate of elimination increases. Often, a discovery group will obtain both IV and oral dosing CP time data together, especially if the lead is intended as an oral drug. Having both the IV and oral data allows determination of all the key pharmacokinetic parameters on the lead. Keep in mind that the data are for an animal, likely rats. Rats are not humans. Regardless, understanding how the molecule behaves in rats greatly assists predictions on how the molecule may behave in humans. The data on the screen are for standard CP time graphs. There is another form in which the same data are presented, as log CP time graphs. On the screen are curves for the same data, but the y-axis is natural log CP instead of just CP. Again, the left shows an IV bolus and the right shows oral administration. In this form, the data look a bit more similar in that the latter half of both curves provide a straight line. Both lines have approximately the same slope. We'll see why this is important in a later video. When examining CP time data, it is important to check the y-axis of the graph and to determine whether the y-axis is linear, CP, which we saw on the previous slide, or logarithmic, either natural log ln(e) or log base e, or regular logarithm, which is log base 10, normally written plain log. Both forms of the graph are useful for determining different information about a molecule's PK. Now that we're familiar with how these data are presented, we can discuss how to use the data to learn about the PK of a molecule. I hope you found this video helpful. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment or question. Take care.